Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us is capitalized interest. So what this topic is all about, that's what we are going to discuss here. See, there are a few interest that is capitalized and there are a few which are not capitalized, but it is actually expensed out. So what sort of interest is capitalized? Okay, that's a very difficult question and a very important question overall. So first and the foremost thing we'll learn is what is capitalized interest. See, capitalized interest is the interest accrued during the construction of what we call as long-term assets and is included in the initial cost of assets on the balance sheet instead of being charged off as the interest expense on the income statement. For example, let's say if a 5% interest rate on, let's talk about 1 lakh, loan which is borrowed to construct windmills, it takes 1 year to complete the construction. So this implies that the cost of the windmill will not only include the initial cost of asset but also the interest expense which has been incurred here, which is required to be paid off for the load. So the total cost will be 1 lakh into 5%, so we'll add this 5,000 with 1 lakh, that's going to be 1,05,000. So here, please, you need to note one thing, that you know, interest expense is not reported in the income statement, whereas the capitalized interest is added to the cost of the long-term assets. See, under the accrual basis of accounting, on the accrual basis of accounting, it is reported in the balance sheet as the total amount of fixed assets. An organization using the construction loan to build its own corporate headquarters is another example of such situation. Now, the capitalization interest becomes a part of the long-term asset and is depreciated. It is depreciated over the useful life. Okay, now let's go to the next topic. This was the first one. What exactly was the capitalized interest? Now, the steps to calculate capitalization interest. What are the steps? Okay, we'll start with that. Step number one is find the capitalization period. So the first step is to understand the time period until when the construction of the fixed assets will take place and by when the assets will be ready for the use. So capitalization of the borrowing cost terminates when the asset has been prepared its intended use and has substantially completed all the activities that are needed. So the capitalization period will not be extended by work minor modification. So if the entity can use some parts while construction continues on the other parts, then it should discontinue the capitalization of the borrowing cost on the part that it completes. Step number two, calculate the weighted average accumulated expenditure. If the product of the expenditure for the construction of a fixed assets and its time weighted for the accounting year, weighted average accumulated expenditure is equal to the expenditure that you incur into number of months in capitalization divide by 12. Step number three. The step three goes as, you need to determine the interest on the specific borrowing and from the general funds you need to figure out. So if the loan was specifically used for the construction of the fixed asset, okay, then the actual borrowing cost incurred is the borrowing cost to capitalize minus the borrowing cost less any kind of investment income earned from the interim investment of those borrowing. Now, for general corporate needs, the borrowing may be handled certainly centrally and could be obtained via a variety of debt instruments. During the period applicable to the asset, in this case, gain an interest rate from the weighted average of the entity's borrowing cost using the method number of allowable borrowing cost at the entity's total borrowing cost during the applicable period. The step four is calculate the avoidable interest. So for calculating the capitalized interest cost, we need to calculate the avoidable interest. Well, it is calculated as WAE, that is weighted average accumulated expenditures into appropriate interest rate, right? So by that we receive avoidable interest right? This capitalize the avoidable interest expense. You need to capitalize the same. Finally, step number 5, calculate the actual interest on loans. Okay, so actual interest on the overall loan is straightforward, and you can calculate directly by multiplying the corresponding interest rate to the debt that has been raised. And step 6, which is the final step, select the lower of the actual interest and avoidable interest as capitalization interest. So capitalization interest is going to be lower of the actual interest and the avoidable interest. Well, this was our second discussion. The third discussion is going to be an example on this. Let's say there is a construction company. Okay, they started a construction of building that is to be used for production, and the construction of the building will end on, let's say, 31st of December, and the building will be ready to use. There were the following, you know, debt outstanding. It was on the 1st of January 2017. 60,000 at $60,000 at 10%. Okay, interest rate taken from the specific purpose of construction of building, and 75,000, 8% interest rate. That was basically general loan that was taken, right? So the payments were made for the construction of the building that was on the 1st of Feb, and that was made closely to 50,000. And on the August month, 1st of August, that was closely 75,000. So you need to calculate the capitalized interest. So I want you all to solve this example by yourself, by applying all the steps over here. The steps could be quite helpful, and based on that, just make the calculations and come up with the answer. The answer of the capitalization interest is going to be $7,367, and try and match your answer with the same. Let me give my final conclusion wordings on this. See, to set the acquiring assets up to the intended use for a period of time, capitalized interest is part of the historical cost, and the gap allows the firm to avoid expense interest on the debt. As many companies finance the construction of long-term assets with either it's going to be debt, and it includes on its balance sheet as a component of the historical cost, that is basically a long-term assets. So various production facilities, ships, real estates involves long-term assets for which the capitalization interest is allowed, and inventories that are manufactured over and over again in the large quantities, capitalization interest is not permitted for. But that's it for this particular topic.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.